Hey, good morning, everyone. So I am out here. Oh, see, sorry about that camera thing. Okay, so I am out here in little adventure today. And spirit, it's been a few days. I took a break. It's been a few days. Thank you so much also for everyone who has given me feedback saying they listen to these videos and that they love them. That's amazing for me, because I just really want to be of inspiration to everyone. So I decided to take some time this morning and just talk. We're just gonna channel, okay? And go ahead and click the subscribe button. And my website's always in the description box. So let's channel this morning about like there's so many like things happening in the world, and there is. This is what I believe psychically, okay? This is what I got like intuitively. There will be an increase in HIV cases coming up. Okay, there will probably be an increase. So live your life accordingly with that information. I try to empower everyone with information. This is not political on either side. I'm not a victim of anything, but I want everyone to know we might see an increase in HIV cases, and there may be a new something going on with that. There's like a connection with that. I've been getting that for a while. So, just live your life accordingly to that. I try to give you information, necessary information. Also, we're going to be living somewhat of a normal life. All of us will go back to what seems normal, not like entirely normal. Nothing's the same. We can never go backwards in life. We just can't. But we will go back in. We're going to integrate our new reality into our lives, just like we have with every other thing, you know, the world has sort of like catapulted into, and we're going to be, it's going to be about 2027, 2028 before we see something else happen to the world. And I don't know why things happen. Like, I don't know why crisis has happened in the world. I really don't, you know, I've been doing this work for years, and there's sometimes I'm like, you know what? I just don't know, you know, on big things and little things, I'll have to look at somebody sometimes and say, you know what? I just don't know why bad things happen sometimes. We've seen such an increase in grief and depression. Cool. That was thunder. Okay. Grief, depression, anxiety. It's like the world is crying or something. And we have to rise above that. And rise above that, meaning we have to like know that it is our job to hold light. That's really your only job is to hold light. It's just to hold light. That's all I'm getting. Without responding, without reacting, just be a grounding presence for yourself, your family, and your community, holding light and living your best life, whatever that looks like, without judgment. Doesn't matter like what people think, what people see, what people do. You just hold light for yourself, your family, and your community, and share joy. Like, someone needs to hear this. You're not a taskmaster. You're not just out completing tasks. You know, we flow with life. We integrate into the flow. And you know, if it's a matter of like, that's why stiffness happens in our body, because we don't flow. And oftentimes, flowing doesn't mean that we necessarily agree with everything that's happening, or that we disagree necessarily, or that things are going our way. Flow just means we flow, right? We're flexible. We're not tripping over ourselves, our ego. We're not, oftentimes, I've been pondering this all week with every like sort of like confusion I have in my head sometimes, right? Because even like everyone has that, like everyone has stuff. I always look at it and go, is this my ego saying that it doesn't look the way I think it should look? Or is this like my true like intuitive hit? So that's very important to discern. Like, sometimes when I'm upset about a situation, I'll be like, wow, is that just because my ego doesn't think it should look that way? It doesn't like the picture in my head. Like, is anything actually happening bad? Is anything actually wrong? And oftentimes it's not. Oftentimes I'm like, no, it really is just my ego saying I don't like the way this looks, right? And then you back up, and then I back up, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna flow. I'm gonna stand in my power with it. So keep that in mind. We're always sort of in that process of like shifting out ego and shifting out opinions and biases and trauma into shifting into like grace and ease and flow, and finding joy in our life, finding a way to live ecstatically. And we are still allowed to do that. We're still allowed to find joy and peace and bliss and live ecstatically, regardless of what's happening in the world or what we may see coming in our feeds of TV and social media and such. Feel good, because that's how you lift other people up. When you feel good, you give other people permission to feel good. When you release trauma, when you release negativity, when you release like opinions and stress, it really sets everyone free, because freedom really is love. Anything that hinders freedom is not love. It might be a version of love or a theory of love. We're not, that's not what love is. Everyone's free in love. When you find true love, you feel free. You don't feel staggered. You don't feel, oh my goodness, I can't do that. I can't shine my brightest. I can't do my best. Because I'm living in relation to restriction, right? Like, look at who you, what you live in relation to. Are we, you living in relation to like an illness? Are you living in relation to a person, a crisis, an event? Or are you living at peace with yourself, like content in the moment, content with what you have? Because that's manifestation. Manifestation is like a tricky thing, right? It's like contentment. Be content with what you have. Be like, wow, I really love the house I'm in. I really love the car I drive. And also be like, and maybe one day I can have that mansion. Maybe one day I can have that Mercedes. Maybe one day I can have that, $1 million, that thriving, whatever. So, but the first step is contentment and gratefulness and gratitude. That's the first step to manifestation. Otherwise, you're constantly chasing something that you're trying to fill yourself up, and you fill yourself up just with love and light. You fill yourself up with joy. You fill yourself up with being alive, because we should thoroughly be enjoying living, being alive. And I don't know how that got taken out of our society. I don't know how that got taken out of our like churches and school systems, just to fall in love with being alive and fall in love with yourself. So write down, like everyone's got three steps to how they got to where you're at today. So write down those three steps. How did you get to where you're at today? Did you say screw it and run, screw it and do it, right? Did you say screw it and like, or just take that leap of faith? Or were you just sort of tousled through life, sort of tousled here? Some people say, oh, I created this reality. And some people say, no, I never felt like I had choice. So those are two different mindsets of people that I talk to, which is amazing. So remember, that's what I have for you today. Spirit's like cutting me off, but take care of yourself, your family, and your community. And those are the steps to empowerment, entrepreneurship, and elegance, okay? Because that's what we're all striving for, and we all deserve to live our best life. And remember to navigate this reality accordingly for your, taking care of yourself, your family, and community, and empower yourself with as much information as possible. Thank you so much for listening. Namaste.